31-31 series rolls on today. The Colorado Avalanche, last season, Mike, the most improved team in the league by far. It wasn't even close. Nearly doubled their points, 48 the year before, 95 points last year.
So as you wrap your head around it.
As you were saying before we started this, you predicted them to be the most improved team last season, but
I didn't predict them to make the playoffs, so don't give me too much credit.
75 points last year would have been a...
I was having fun with numbers.
Right,
yes, exactly.
Fun with numbers, but they were. They made the playoffs with 95 points last year. Now, they did lose to the Nashville Predators in the first round in 16. They gave Nashville a run.
More trouble than they thought we'd give them.
This year now, they've added another goaltender in Philip Grubauer in a trade with the Washington Capitals to compete with Semyon Varlamov, who we know has health issues at times, but can be very good as well. 24-16-6 and a .920 save percentage last year. So their goaltending ideally should be better. They've got McKinnon, they've got Rantanen, and now they've got some expectations. Because they were a playoff team.
Yeah.
How do you think they handle that?
I think they probably handle it internally just fine. Mm-hmm. I think they have the kind of group that was probably a little embarrassed about the year a couple years ago.
Definitely.
And really responded nicely last year to a lot of people, again, questioning how good they might be in, and you know, dealing with the Duchene trade and everything else, and then really thriving down the stretch and winning big games and pushing Nashville in the playoffs.
They won to get in.
Yeah, that last game. Yeah. So lots of things to build off of. The difference, I think, this year won't be internally, it'll be externally. How do other teams view Colorado? How do other teams approach Colorado? Yep. That will become harder because they'll get their attention now. Even after the good start, I imagine December, January, teams are still thinking, yeah, this roster, they were really bad last year. Maybe we start the backup goalie, maybe we'll be okay. That won't be the case. Teams will come ready to play them, and that will make their year more difficult.
And I think one of the most interesting questions with the Avalanche this season, because of the addition of Grubauer, who we know was good in the regular season last year with the Washington Capitals, and to me earned the start in game one against Columbus, and was the right move by Barry Trotz to go to Holtby eventually, and obviously we know how that worked out quite well. But Grubauer, 15-10-3, a .923, and a .235 with the Capitals last year. Do you think he pushes Varlamov? Do you think Grubauer eventually becomes the number one this season with this team?
I think if they both play their best, Varlamov's the better goalie.
Okay.
But I think it offers great safety, security, insurance, because we also know, unfortunately, Varlamov has a history of injuries, groins, hips, the way he plays, the way he body responds to some of the wear and tear. So if he has to go down, he almost does every single year, unfortunately, and misses 2 weeks, 3 weeks, you have such a capable guy. And maybe, just maybe, because you have Grubauer, Varley doesn't have to play so much.
Right.
Right? You don't have to play him three out of four. You can kind of rotate the guys through a little bit more often to manage his body so that he doesn't have any of those stretches. So I think for that reason, it's a good addition. I don't think, unless Varlamov gets hurt for an extended stretch, that he becomes the number one this year. But again, if Varlamov leaves after his contract expires,
that's why he's there, and that's why they acquired him.
Yeah.
And I think this team, I think Colorado's a team with those two goaltenders, you're going to see maybe not an even split, but as close to an even split as you'll get
with
starts.
But I think Colorado would want that.
That's what they're looking for.
Because of the health of Varlamov and his history.
Absolutely. They're looking for that, and they're looking for whoever plays better down the stretch to be their goalie in the playoffs, because I think they're a playoff team.
You're going right back there.
I'm going right there.
Okay, before we get there, I want a second-line center.
Okay,
because we know their first line, incredible.
Sure,
right?
You want to go through another question?
No, I got to go one more, though, because I'm going to just have a little spotlight.
Right.
Whether it's Kerfoot, who played a little bit there last
year.
Whether it's Tyson Jost this year, really high pick from a couple years ago. One of those two guys, whoever plays there, I think that's one of the two will start there.
Yeah, probably, because Soderberg's your three.
Ideally.
You know, so I think they would like Tyson Jost to be that guy.
I think they want, they picked him with that in mind.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, and I'm not saying he can't do it.
Right.
But he hasn't, and he hasn't been given that kind of responsibility, that kind of opportunity.
Yep.
And so how he plays there, I think, will help smooth out their transition to being a perennial contender.
Sure.
Because you can't just, as great as that first line was last year, and they were great, you need more below it, and I think it'll be Jost, Kerfoot, their chance to drive.
Comfort too. JT Comfort's
a good player. Yeah.
I don't think he's at the level of Tyson Jost or Kerfoot to be in that spot.
Yeah.
But ideally, if it breaks out for them, they have McKinnon, Jost, Soderberg, Comfort, maybe Kerfoot. They have options.
Some pieces that
they
if it doesn't work, they can go other ways.
They have options there.
One of those guys you just mentioned, that if it's not going to be Jost or Kerfoot, one of those guys got to step in there and put a pretty consistent offensive year together.
But back to it, I think they're a playoff team again. Do you?
I don't.
No? All right.
I don't think they're going to fall back to being 70 points.
Right,
I just think that the improvements, St. Louis has gotten better. Dallas, New, you know, there's other teams in the Central. Even if five teams come out of the Central, it's still, oh, you trust in Nashville and you trust in Winnipeg. It's going to be very, very tough. So if they fall back to 93 points, or they're going to be right around it, they may just come up short.
I think they're going to be right around it and come up on the other side of it and go to the playoffs. And the reason I do, they didn't do a ton. They added Grubauer, they added Cole and Matt Calvert. So they didn't do a ton to really, you know, really boost them up tremendously. Grubauer could be, you know, certainly somebody who, you know, who turns out to be special for them. But there's going to be growth from within, too. Like, I think a Tyson Jones gets better. I think a Kerfoot, Confort, I think these guys will get better. And that's where you're going to see the growth of Colorado Avalanche.
Can that first line do it again this year?
Boy, that's going to be hard to do it again.
They can have great years and not do as well.
But that's why you need the growth.
That's what I'm saying. But like, maybe that growth just equals out the inevitable fall off.
If it equals out, they'll get in the playoffs again.
By one?
By one.
Close.
There you go. I say yes, he says no.